From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Health Minister Redwood Wells said the country is expected to receive its first doses of the Pfizer vaccine through the World Health Organization's COVAX facility soon, with additional doses of the brand anticipated to arrive in the country later this year. Speaking to reporters before yesterday's cabinet meeting, Mr. Wells said the first shipment of the Pfizer vaccine will consist of 57,330 doses and added that officials are hoping to have those vaccines here by the end of the month. The minister said, quote, "We will have a more definitive date when the Pfizer vaccine will arrive in the country by Friday of this week. The COVAX facility through PAHO has informed the Caribbean region as to what is available, and the Bahamas has been offered some 57,330 doses of Pfizer through PAHO. You would also be aware that we are entitled to some 33,000+ doses of AstraZeneca. The date for arrival of the vaccine is July 26th, and so we are eagerly awaiting AstraZeneca on July 26th. We're also awaiting the update through CARICOM for the donation directly from the United States as to how much doses of that vaccine we will be receiving. We should have that update this week as well." The news comes amid concerns about low vaccine supply in the country, with vaccination sites only showing available bookings online until late July. Despite a recent spate of murders over the holiday weekend, National Security Minister Marvin Dames said Bahamians have no reason to feel unsafe, insisting police have the crime situation under control. Mr. Dames spoke after five men were killed in separate incidents between Thursday and Monday, sparking renewed public concerns about violent crimes. Police suspect some of the crimes are linked and are the result of retaliation between rival groups. Well, yesterday, Mr. Dames said while overall crime continues to trend downward, the most recent incidents prove there is still work to be done. He said many of the country's crime problems stem from decades of neglect by Bahamian parents and adults. The hotel union's president said yesterday that industry workers were yet to feel the benefits from tourism's post-COVID resurgence, with no higher than 40% of his members recalled to work to date. Darren Woods, Bahamas Hotel Catering and Allied Workers Union's chief, told the Tribune that a lot of people are still at home, while branding the number of staff recalled to resort properties where the union is represented as sluggish, voicing hope that tourism's recovery will maintain its present pace through the traditionally slow months of September and October, so that recalled hotel workers will earn sufficient income to carry them through to Christmas 2021. He added that those still on furlough are increasingly struggling to make ends meet almost 17 months into the pandemic. Nassau Cruise Port's top executive yesterday said it could welcome 1 million visitors over the 5 months to year-end 2021, even if vessels call with just 60% average occupancy. Michael Mora told the Tribune that there is a lot more activity on the horizon at Prince George Wharf, with a total 520 cruise ship visits scheduled between August 1 and year-end as the industry ramps up its return to the seas following a 15-month COVID-enforced absence. He said the cruise lines had indicated that as they become more confident in their health protocols and virus testing regimes on board, occupancy levels will steadily increase from the present 30% throughout the remainder of 2021 until 100% is achieved before 2022 is reached. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, overdose deaths soared to a record 93,000 last year in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, the U.S. government reported today. That estimate far eclipses the high of about 72,000 drug overdose deaths reached the previous year and amounts to a 29% increase. "This is a staggering loss of human life," said Brandon Marshall, a Brown University public health researcher who tracks overdose trends. The nation was already struggling with its worst overdose epidemic, but clearly, COVID-19 has greatly exacerbated the crisis, he added. Lockdowns and other pandemic restrictions isolated those with drug addictions and made treatment harder to get, experts have said. South African police and the army struggled to bring order today to impoverished areas of South Africa, rocked by week-long unrest and days of looting sparked by the imprisonment last week of ex-president Jacob Zuma. More than 200 violent incidents happened in those poor areas, the government said today, a week after the protests started. The deployment of army soldiers to assist police has been doubled to 5,000 after the days of rioting in which more than 72 people have been killed and 1,234 arrested, according to police. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. The northern extent of a tropical wave moving westwards across South Florida will trigger a few lingering showers and thunderstorms across portions of the northwest Bahamas as it continues to exit the area. Meanwhile, high pressure will progressively build in its wake through tonight. Boaters in the extreme northwest Bahamas should remain vigilant due to the risk of possible waterspout activity. Beachgoers should exercise caution due to the slight risk of rip currents along northern and eastern shorelines. For all areas, it'll be variably cloudy, hot, and a bit breezy, with a few passing showers and isolated thunderstorms mainly occurring offshore in the extreme northwest Bahamas through tonight. Expect gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds northeast to east at 15 knots, seas 4 to 6 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 75. The sun will set this afternoon at 8 p.m. and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:29. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.